Hello and welcome. How are you doing today? Today I am planning to inform you that why, in my understanding, these Toyota engines start to consume motor oil. And this is just specific Toyota's engines issue. And I have experience in this Toyota's oil consumption in like now 20 years, and there is situation that normally these Toyota's engines, they are so fantastic, durable, and these motors last hundreds of thousand miles, something like 400 or 500,000 miles. And just like in here, when I have this cylinder block, where is this mileage, there is now this 100,000, and when we look in there inside, I can see those motor, this machinery, those shapes and this small lines in this cylinder head, this cylinder and this engine piston hole, pistons moves in these holes. And this means that now these holes are in good condition. And also, when we think this motor, there is no any oil leaks. But in somehow, these Toyotas, like Toyota Corolla's engines, what are these four-cylinder engines, they start to consume this oil. And this oil consuming starting when there is mileage little bit more than 100,000 miles. And now I tell that what is this reason? The reason is that when we have this piston in here, this looks everything good. This is very high quality piston and all parts are okay. But then there are those rings what make this piston ticked or loose, and that if this piston rings are very good, then this pressure and oil are in different location, and there is, I have here two pistons, and normally in these Toyota's motors there are three those piston rings, and in here I have take couple of outs. And the piston ring is that shape, and it fits right in here. There is one similar ring in here, and I have to take that ring away. And these two pistons, this meaning is that they must to keep this gasoline and then this fire exposition pressure in only in that area, what is in this up area. And in this below area, there is oil working in that line. What is in here? I saw that where is this oil line? Oil line is just in here, and there we can see this one ring, piston ring, and this ring's name is oil ring, and it is the ring where are those holes. If you look. And normally this Toyota's issue is that this oil ring, it becomes old and stuck. And it is not so anymore so elastic. And this last ring start to move this oil in that area. This is full of oil in that line. Actually this oil is spraying in this area, and in that area oil goes right away, and when this oil ring becomes old, then this oil can go in so up like in here, and I think that these black things tells that there has been this maybe a little bit oil leak. I'm not sure, but in this oil ring is the issue and the beef of this case. And how then we could fix that. There is very easy thing. We need to replace these oil rings in all pistons. And then this oil consumption stops. And also when we change those pressure two rings to in this upper area, then this motor is running very nicely. And then I saw that how this oil ring is working. Now I have take those pressure rings out, and then I insert that piston. What number is 4? And number 4 is in that piston. I insert that in here, and this there is at least so much this pressure in this oil ring that this piston don't drop even in down. If this is so really old car, this and really worn out this piston, then this piston can really drop down in this hole, and then this engine is really really bad, and it consumes a huge amount of oil. But now when I think that this is at least in this thick, that this can keep this piston in here, I think that this is not this. So this is not defect piston and defect, and there is no defect in this oil ring. I think that this ring, oil ring is just okay. But then when I look this oil ring, normally this oil ring, when I rotate this ring, this should little bit move. But this is totally stuck in here. It don't move anything. When we compare in this the other piston, where is this one this pressure, it should work at least a little bit. And this ring is also very stuck in this oil. And when I try to rotate, this oil ring don't move. Okay, and this was the information why some Toyotas can to start consume oil. And there is one good, actually some kind of hint, that if your car start this Toyota engine start to consume oil, then it's good that you drive in your car very lower turn rates, and this means that then this piston speed in these holes is slower, and then this bad oil ring can move this oil away. And next I think that we could do this oil ring test, and it happens so that I insert this piston back in here, and I actually insert two pistons, and then we insert in their gasoline, and we check that how this how thick are these piston rings, and in this third piston ring I think that I keep in there this oil ring and one pressure ring. Okay, and then I start to first I need to clean this piston, because there all parts must be clean. I have cotton cloth in here, and I clean that, and then then I insert this piston back in here this way, and now there is this oil ring is there. Okay, and then I am planning to insert this piston back in there, and for that I need a couple of screwdrivers and also a hammer that I can carefully hammer this, and then I start to press this piston in there, and it's good to use their little bit oil, and I take my oil can. And here is my oil. And when there comes this oil, okay, now there is oil, and I give a little bit in here this oil that this piston should go in there better. Actually, I give this oil in this oil ring. Oil helps, and okay, and then I insert this piston back in there, and now I think that there is, I need to put a bit hammer this. Okay, now on every side, and now this oil ring is there, and then I need to little bit hammer this more, and then I have to rotate this piston ring. You can see that there is this piston ring, and I am moving this hole in here. There is this hole here, just that where is those piston ring, and then I press this piston in that way, and then I press, and then I take my hammer and I carefully look all sides in here, and I press this piston in there. Now it's in there, good. Now I am now using two those screwdrivers at the same time. Okay, and then I am pressing in this ring in both sides, that this ring is in this inside. There's my second piston, and there's idea that when I have insert this piston in there, I insert this ring in there. There's idea that when I press this piston in there, it goes in so deep, like in here, not in this way. And I press in both sides, and when this hole is so small, then I know that now this piston can go. Okay, and then I continue to insert this piston in this piston hole, and there was situation that this is in now in there, and when we look, I have pressed all of those sides in inside in this piston hole, and I have in here this another, and in piston hole I have pressed that ring in there. And now I think that I can little bit hammer this piston carefully, really carefully. Because if I hammer like in this very hard hit, like in this way, very hard, then this piston ring, it will be broken in this side. And now I have pressed that ring in this way, but if, and now this ring is in this piston hole, and I carefully insert this piston in back, and it's good to hammer in very carefully in here, and my hits are so hit that so small that I can hit my finger. This is the force. Now this piston is in there. And then we I a little bit add in that. And next we can do this test that how this oil ring and this piston can keep this gasoline, because this gasoline is more flexible than oil, and that's the reason I like test that how well this one piston ring and one oil ring. I have now like this limited amount. Normally there is two rings in here, like in this way. But now I have only one ring and one oil ring, and then I add in here this gasoline. And next I go to take a little bit gasoline and we look that. And here is my gasoline, and I add in there a little bit gasoline, and we look that what happened. And when we are doing those thickness tests, it's always good to use same liquid what works in this piston area. And now there is this gasoline, and let's check that how is there any leaks in their pillow area. Now I move this engine block a little bit. There is gasoline, good. Then we check that when I move that little bit, that is there any leaks in there. Okay, and there is no any leaks. Excellent. This means that at least this piston is quite okay. There is no any issues. I little bit cool down. Okay. And this was that information that how to test this piston's thickness when we use this gasoline. And then I throw those gasolines to my garbage pot. Okay. And thank you for watching this video.